I think I smell a refund. Hey, you know what? I've recently discovered I have the special ability to predict the minds of Disney fanatics. So who here is crazy for Disney? All right, I need one person who's crazy for Disney to... not yet. Thank you very much, though. See, what I have done, I've placed a prediction in here of a famous celebrity, a famous person. And I need someone, a Disney fanatic, just to shout out the name of a famous celebrity. Who? Miley Cyrus. Ma'am, stand up. I'm not sure quite where that came from. Right there. Miley Cyrus. Ma'am, have we ever met before? We haven't met before? You seem proud of that. Hey, ma'am, would you be amazed if in this envelope is a picture of Miley Cyrus? Would you be amazed? Yeah? Ladies and gentlemen, prepare to be amazed. Miley Cyrus, 3 months, 2 weeks. Yeah, you think this is easy? Last show, someone said Barack Obama. I know what he's thinking. It's time for change! Woo! But no, I actually need a few Disney fanatics to help me out. So if you're crazy for Disney, make some noise, but stay where you're sitting. Not again. Come right onto the stage for me. Not again. One time. Right up onto the stage. And looks like a Disney fanatic right here. Sir, come right up here onto the stage, right this way. Watch your step, come right up. Again. Let's hear it for your Disney fanatics! Thank you very much. Now, guys, here's what we're going to do. In just a moment, I'm going to ask each of you a question. All right? There's no wrong answer, so don't feel no pressure. When I ask you a question, just think of an answer. Think of the answer pictured in your mind. The only rule is don't tell anybody what you're thinking. Can you guys do that? All right. Let's start right here in the front. What is your name? Ezekiel? Ezekiel, how old are you?
Eight.
You're eight also? Do you guys call them on the same bus? This is cool. Hey, Ezekiel, I want you to think of a cartoon character. But don't tell anybody who you're thinking of, okay? So go ahead and think about one. Do you have one in your mind? Yeah? Cool. Ezekiel, here's what I want you to do. I want you to picture that cartoon character in your mind. Look me dead in the eyes and send me your thoughts. I think I got this one. For the first time out loud, Ezekiel, tell everybody who you were just thinking of.
Donald Duck.
Donald Duck? It's not funny. Donald Duck. Ezekiel, I got a question. Was the music loud enough? Could you hear it okay? Yeah? All right. Do me a favor. Step to the back of the line. You guys take a step this way, right to the back of the line. Sir, what's your name?
Chris.
Chris, where are you from?
Roanoke, Virginia.
All right. Chris, what I want you to do is, I want you to think of your favorite toy. Now remember, this is a family show. All right. Chris, think about a toy. Do you have one? Do you need a phone a friend? you have one?
Sure.
Oh, all right. Now, don't change your mind, Chris. Picture that toy in your mind. Look me dead in the eyes and send me your thoughts.
Oh, rubber ducky, you're the one. You make bath time lots of fun. Rubber ducky, I'm awfully fond of you. Vote-o.
I think I got this one. For the first time out loud, please tell everybody exactly what toy you were just thinking of.
Tennis racket.
Tennis racket? Okay, Chris, get all macho on me now. Tennis racket. You know, it's okay. It's okay, because, you know, each one of these has thousands upon thousands of potentially correct answers. So as long as I got one of these right, it'd still be like counting a miracle. Chris, do me a favor. Step into the back of the line. You guys take a step this way. And what's your name?
Emma.
Emma, where are you from?
England
in the house. Emma, I want you to think of a television show. Any television show out of the millions on TV, think of one. Do you have one? All right. Now picture that show in your mind. And Emma, send me your thoughts.
You get the best of both worlds.
Emma, don't pay any attention to the lunatic behind the curtain. wait, send me those thoughts. Send me them. Send me. I think I got one. All right. Perfect. Go ahead, for the first time out loud, please tell everybody exactly what show you were just thinking of. You know, this is only my career here. You know what, do me a favor, take a step forward for me just a little bit, okay? Cause if we what?
Montana.
Yeah, you said Hannah Montana, right?
No, I said
fine. See, no, I was trying to do it was deep down in Emma's heart. Yeah. Got the best, okay. Get this back here. Sudden burst of gravity. Let's see. You said who? SpongeBob SquarePants. What's your car? What are we doing here? SpongeBob SquarePants. All right, perfect. Oh, thank you. Mrs. Nice to be here. Ladies and gentlemen, fifth grade teacher's in the house tonight. Not really. But Emma, you know what? Get back in line. Just kidding. Because I got to admit, ladies and gentlemen, this has been a total waste of 5 minutes. But if I got even close to one of these, like maybe the same television station or something, it might not be too bad. So let's see how we did. Let's see. Ziggle, you were thinking of Donald Duck. Any cartoon character you named Donald Duck. Well, you know what? It's really cool because I think I had a connection with you today because you are a Disney fanatic, and I thought he would actually say, ladies and gentlemen, Donald Duck! But then we went to Chris, and he was thinking tennis racket as a toy. It's a grown-up toy, very cool. But, you know, again, I think we're on the same wavelength because you said, or I said, a tennis racket! Oh, yeah, then there was Emma. Went straight to Nickelodeon. I didn't quite get as good a connection with you. But at least 2 out of 3 is not bad. Well, 3 out of 3 would be better. Ladies and gentlemen, SpongeBob! Yeah! Emma! Thank you very much for helping out, Chris. Thank you very much. Ezekiel, give me 5. Yeah! Hey, would you guys like to see one more?
Yeah!
You want to see one more?
Yeah!
Awesome, because I brought with me a very special present right back here. It's about 12 inches in every direction. But what's really cool is I brought this with me right here. Now, this is a very special mirror. What's special about it? It's special because it allows you not only see what's going on above the present, below the present, on both sides of the present, but more importantly, what's going on behind the present at all times. Now, I know a few of you, you go downstairs, you grab the presents around the house, you look at them, you shake them, you try to figure out what's inside. Well, I've discovered a way to package presents that no matter what you do, you will not figure out what's inside that package. Check this out.
Please go wild and crazy for Joseph Constantine and KC! One more time, let them hear you, Joseph Constantine and KC! Well, thank you, ladies and gentlemen, girls and boys, for joining us for Cabaret Showtime. Don't forget, we've got Disney Dreams taking place in the Walt Disney Theater in about 30 minutes' time. And of course, a lot of you will be going to dinner as well, but...